Hi, my name is Manuela Dalibor. I'm a PhD student at RWTH Aachen University at the Chair of Software Engineering, headed by Professor Rumpe. Today I present the paper Model-Driven Development of a Digital Twin for Injection Molding. This paper presents work that we did together with our colleagues from the Institute for Plastics Processing in Industry and Craft. And the whole topic originates from a common project, the Excellence Cluster Internet of Production at our university. Smart manufacturing uses connected devices to monitor production processes and thus gain insight about the state of the process and the involved machines. It advances the automation of processes and uses, for example, data analysis methods to improve production performance by deriving smart plans for the data. We define a digital twin as a software system that consists of a set of models of the CPPS, a set of digital shadows, and that provides a set of services to use the data and models purposefully with respect to the original system. As such, the digital twin is a virtual replica of the physical system, since it always represents the system's state, but it also provides services that help to optimize the underlying system. Digital shadows are a set of temporal data traces and their aggregation and abstraction that are collected concerning a system for a specific purpose with respect to the original system. The digital shadow encapsulates exactly the data that the digital twin requires for performing its tasks. It may also be reduced. Cyber-physical production systems are equipped with sensors that produce large amounts of data while they are running. Since these amounts cannot be analyzed efficiently, digital shadows are reduced to exactly those data that are required for the digital twin to perform its tasks. Injection molding is a highly automated mass production process. It works by injecting a molten plastic material into a mold and under high pressure waiting until it is cooled. During this process, it hardens and takes on the configuration of the mold cavity. The configuration of the injection molding process is time consuming since manual experiments are necessary to determine the ideal parameter settings for producing high-quality parts. For example, the temperature is a sensitive value since a high temperature may cause decomposition, while if the temperature is not hot enough, the mold is not completely filled. Injection molding thus serves as the use case and a representative for a smart production system in our paper. Our research goals are the following. First, we want to develop a model-driven methodology for efficiently developing digital twins of cyber-physical production systems. So far, there exist multiple realizations of digital twins, but they are usually for one specific use case and cannot be generalized. Second, we want to develop a reference architecture that we evaluate on our use case injection molding. We also want to support the development of digital twins by providing domain-specific languages that help connecting the twin to its physical counterpart. And we want to derive modeling techniques that help to specify the digital twin's behavior. In the following, I will first present the digital twin architecture that we developed and then explain the event language framework that we use for describing the digital twin behavior. We modeled our digital twin in MontiArch. This is an architecture description language developed at our chair with the language workbench MontiCore. It consists of components, and these components have typed and directed interfaces that are specified by explicit ports. By defining the digital twin in components, we ensure that it is developed modular. This also means that one component always encapsulates a subset of the digital twin's functionality and can be exchanged if we want to, for example, add new additional functionality. This also ensures that all components are reusable, since they can also be taken to realize other applications. MontiArch has already different generators, for example, for Java and Python. Thus, the development of the digital twin can also be automated highly. At the bottom of our architecture, you see the cyber-physical production system. So in our case, this would be the injection molding machine. The machine has an interface for sending commands and can also give feedback about the execution of these commands. It also is equipped with sensors that measure and capture the state of the production process. Since these sensors collect large amounts of data, they are first stored in the data lake. The data lake is a massive storage of data and may contain different databases that collect data from various resources. So apart from the sensors of the CPPS, there may also be databases that store sensor values from the context of the cyber-physical production system, for example, the production plant. But it may also contain user data about machine operators. The digital twin is composed of 5 components. The first component is the data processor. Internally, it is structured as an adapter and a logic component. The adapter knows how to access the databases of the data lake, whereas the logical component takes the collected data and creates digital shadows. That means it creates data objects that encapsulate exactly the information that is required by the digital twin. These data objects, the digital shadows, are evaluated by the evaluator component. For detecting whether the cyber-physical production system works as intended, the evaluator relies on knowledge that it can gain from the knowledge base. If it detects an unintended behavior or a state that is not good, it creates a goal which specifies which property of the production system should be adapted. This goal is handed over to the reasoner component. The reasoner component is the smart component of the digital twin. It contains its decision-making functionalities, can rely on knowledge to derive plans and solutions for the goals that are sent by the evaluator. If it creates a solution, it hands this solution over to the executor. The executor internally contains adapters that help to access the cyber-physical production system or the context of the system. These adapters send concrete commands to the system and thus ensure that the solution is executed. It also relies on feedback from the system and its context to ensure that the solution is performed correctly. We figured that a common task of a digital twin is to monitor a cyber-physical system and react to events that occur within the system. For example, if sensor values change or if the machine sends any information. Thus, we developed a language framework for defining events. The language framework is developed in MontiCore. That means that we give a grammar as language specification that describes which elements have to be part of a model of this language. And from such a grammar description, we can derive tooling, for example, for parsing models and processing them. The grammar contains interfaces. These specify at which points the language can be adapted to more specific domains. As in our case, we adapted this language to injection molding. An event model starts with the keyword behavior, and this is followed by the name of the model. It contains a list of events, rules, and actions. An event, specified by the interface symbol event definition in line 6, always must have at least a unique name that is used for referencing this event. The same holds for action definitions in line 7. We also have an implementation for a simple rule that maps an event to one or multiple actions. The meaning of such mapping is that if the event occurs, that is, if some evaluation evaluates this event to true, the actions that are mapped to this event are executed. This grammar can be extended by other languages to represent domain-specific elements. Our framework also provides code generators that derive infrastructure from models that describe events. These templates can also be extended with more domain-specific code if necessary. They are already integrated with the templates that we use for generating the digital twin from the Monty Arc architecture. They provide hook points where additional templates can be added. A Groovy script takes all templates and generates the digital twin if the generation process is started. Based on the reference architecture that I just presented and basing on the event description language, we specified a digital twin for an injection molding machine that automated the execution of experiments on the machine to identify optimal parameter configurations. The digital twin was developed for an Aarborg Aurora machine that provides an OPC UA interface for accessing the control of the machine and setting parameters. The Institute for Plastics Processing also developed a Kafka cluster that we used for accessing runtime data of the machine and for creating digital shadows. An SQL database stored historical data and helped when the digital twin relied on historical data or the evolution of values for identifying the machine state. For developing the digital twin, we first created a domain model modeled as class diagram. Then we specified events that occur in the system and should trigger the digital twin. Next, we had to specify how the twin can access data about the machine and how it can control the machine by setting parameters. This was done based on domain-specific languages that we developed. After that, we could generate a digital twin and only had to add few handwritten classes to it to make it executable. The injection molding process is divided into several phases. Two of them are the injection and the plasticizing phase. The plasticizing phase has a machine cycle counter that counts how often this phase has been executed already, and it is characterized by the nozzle temperature and the dosing volume that specifies how much material has to be injected. The injection phase starts as soon as the switchover volume is reached. Thus, the switchover volume setting is a characterizing attribute. On the bottom, you would see the events that we specified for our digital twin. Here we worked with an extension of the event language that provides language attributes for specifying Boolean expressions about elements of the class diagram. As you can see, we also have integrated call for Java methods, as for example here the check temperature method in line 4. Since like that we could rely on libraries that already exist. As soon as a new machine cycle starts, the digital twin creates a new digital shadow. Also, as you can see here, we can access the current value with the @ and then 0. So we compare the nozzle temperature at the current point in time and the nozzle temperature of the previous digital shadow. If the event plasticizing ended is evaluated to true, we start the action, start injection phase. This is specified by line 11, where the event plasticizing ended is mapped to the start injection phase action. The data processor
within the digital shadow has to evaluate events and decide whether it has to take actions. The data objects that the data processor accesses are always typed by the class diagram, as for example here, the event plasticizing ended is typed by the plasticizing phase class. If the state attribute changes, that is, if a new machine cycle starts, the data processor creates a new digital shadow. You can see the digital shadow on the right side. There you can see that we have two values for the nozzle temperature, one at the current point in time and the previous value two. Like this, the evaluator can later compare how this value developed over time. For specifying the reasoner, we also developed a domain-specific language that helps domain experts from injection molding to specify the required tests on the machine. They can specify which parameters should be changed during the experiment and which should be the minimal, maximal, and intermediate values. You can see this in line 6, for example, where the switchover volume is varied from 39 to 41. Also, we use the fully factorial design method for specifying how many experiments are necessary. This means that we test each combination of parameter values specified within the design of experiment. These kinds of models are interpreted by the reasoner, and from these, the reasoner creates a solution that it sends to the executor. The executor can then take such a solution and perform experiments on the injection molding machine. To sum up, we modeled a digital twin based on our domain-specific languages and on the reference architecture. We could generate large parts of the digital twin, which reduced manual implementation overhead. The digital twin generates design of experiments and also arranges the planned trials in such a way that it requires the least time. For example, a temperature variation always takes some cycles until the process is balanced again, and by keeping the changes in temperature low for each trial, the twin could reduce the overall time. Also, manual effort for changing the parameter settings during the experiment was reduced. The digital twin accessed the control of the injection molding machine via OPC UA and set the respective values. Even when we had to change to another machine in another location, this took relatively low effort since we simply adapted the models that described how the digital twin should access data about the machine and the machine control and could generate a new digital twin that worked with the other machine too. Also, replacing components within the digital twin, for example, adding a machine learning component within the reasoner, is relatively effortless. Thank you very much for your attention. Also, in the paper, you can find details about the adaptation process for the digital twin architecture if you want to use it in another domain. You can find information about the OPC UA interface description language and how we customize the digital twin event language. More information about model-driven digital twins can be found on our website. And also, if you want to know more about the Excellence Cluster Internet of Production, please refer to the IOP website. Thank you.